do you do?
Good morning, gentlemen. Mr. O'Connor is expecting you. Will you go right in?
Thank you.
Barrow, I told you to transfer some cash to our Paris office. $2 million. You expect them to operate with pennies? Cable them $3 million more right away. Can't I leave this office 5 minutes without things going haywire? Where are those lumber contracts? Well, call San Francisco and tell them if those contracts aren't here tomorrow, the deal is off. Anything happen on that steel mill lease? I don't care what it costs. I want it closed today. Yeah, right. Oh, and by the way, cable Kennedy in London and tell him we'll sell our British and Canadian holdings for $12 million. Yeah, not a cent less. Oh, and if my American can goes up tomorrow, sell 100,000 shares. Ryan. Hello, boys.
Mike! What are you doing behind O'Connor's desk? You gone nuts?
How did you get in here?
We better get him out before O'Connor comes in.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Where's Mr. O'Connor?
We haven't seen him.
We have an appointment with him. What's that?
Well, it ain't mice.
Somebody open this door.
Mr. O'Connor! Mr. O'Connor, what were you doing in that closet?
I like it in there. There's nothing so restful as a nice, dark, stuffy closet.
Did you say Mr. O'Connor?
That's what he said.
Well, how did...
Yeah, no, don't start popping questions. I haven't time. Farrow, where are those papers of transfer?
Right here, sir.
Yeah, good. Now then. Before I transfer this barracks property over to you three gentlemen, there's one thing you must do for me.
Yes, sir?
Not one word of this to McKeever. As far as he is concerned, I'm still just a panhandler. Gentlemen, is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Good. Sit down, make yourself at home.